Hey guys, welcome back on my YouTube channel, and this is the day 23. Okay guys, and today I'm going to talk about optional chaining. So guys, what is optional chaining and what we need to use? So before watching this video, I would like to request kindly go on the previous video and learn about some optionals, and after that you must see this video. Okay guys, so guys, what is the optional chaining and what is the meaning of optional chaining? So guys, if you are having any variable which is holding to an instance, or any kind of instance or any kind of type value, in that case you want to perform operation on that variable, in that case the chain is created. Okay, and that chain is known as optional chaining. Okay, so let me go through one example so that you should have a clear clarity about it. Okay, so let me copy this example and let's go on our playground, and we will do some code so that we can understand the optional chaining. Okay guys, so guys, this is our day 23 playground, and let's paste our code here. So guys, as you can see, we have a class that is election poll class, and it is having a variable of type poll booth. Okay guys, and we have a class that is poll booth and with a value of MP. So let me just leave it. So guys, we have created one instance of the election poll, and we have assigned a candidate name. Okay, so the candidate name we have assigned here, and so how we can get the candidate name? By using this instance. So if I call this instance, and if I am accessing this variable, so as you can see guys, this variable is what guys, it is a optional. So we are just calling this variable, and we are passing a this question mark symbol. So what is the meaning of this symbol? I will tell you, just wait for a moment. Okay, and after that, on this variable I'm calling name variable. Okay, means if I have assigned an instance to this variable, then with the help of this variable I can access this name. Are you getting my point? So until now what we have done, we have created the object of or instance of election poll, but we didn't assign any instance of poll booth to our candidate variable, instance variable. Okay guys, but we are trying to access this variable, and we are trying to perform our operation, means we are trying to access the name of the candidate. Are you getting my point? So this is called a optional chaining. Why it is called optional chaining? Because you are performing a chain of operation on a optional variable. Are you getting my point? So this is our optional, optional instance variable, and this is a reference variable basically. So you are trying to access a name with the help of this reference variable, where this reference variable is an optional kind of thing. Means you are doing a optional chaining. Are you getting my point? So this is how the optional chaining happens. Okay, so after this, now we want to do the optional chaining. So there are two ways. First one is what? Forcefully you will unwrap the variable on which you want to perform the chain of operation. This is the first way. And the second way is what guys? You can put the question mark here. So in this case, first of all, it will it doesn't matter the value is available in the candidate or not, and it will trying to access the name. So there may be two cases. First one is what guys, if the candidate having a instance, then it will successfully retrieve the name. But if in this case, if there is no value, if there is no any instance for the candidate reference variable, in that case your this whole statement is gonna non-executable. Okay, means this whole student statement will not be executed when we have no any instance in this variable. Okay guys, so instead of directly performing this operation, what we can do, we can so let me show you first of all what happens if I trying to access the name and we don't have any instance for candidate. So let's say I want to print this name. Okay, so let's run it and see what happens. So guys, as you can see, it is printing as nil. Why? Because it is returning an optional value. Are you getting my point? This is returning an optional value. Why it is returning? Because this candidate having no any reference or instance variable. Okay, are you getting my point? So what happens if I forcefully unwrap this value, see what happens. So if I run, it is throwing one error. Why? Because you don't have any reference or any instance to this variable. Okay guys, so let's say we are creating one poll booth instance, and we can create like this. Okay, so poll booth is equals to poll booth, and guys, we have created one instance, and let me assign this instance to candidate. Okay, so guys, I have assigned to this candidate. Now guys, if I try to forcefully unwrap the value, so guys, as you can see, it is successfully forcefully unwrapped the value. And what happens if I put the question mark? Then it will perform a chaining operation, means there will be an optional value. So there may be a value or there may not be a value. Okay, so we are using so as you can see guys, it is returning a optional value. Okay, so what is the recommended case? Will I have to use the exclamation mark or the question mark? So guys, if you use the exclamation mark, so there may be a chance your app gonna crash if the value is not found, means if the it is not referring to any instance. Okay, so instead of using this exclamation mark, you should have to use this question mark. The problem is what if we use this question mark, then it is returning an optional kind of value, means we need to unwrap the value. Okay, so the whole statement output will be optional if any one variable is optional. Okay, so how we can unwrap the value guys? So I have told you in the earlier video, in the last video, how we can unwrap the value. So I have shown four ways how you can unwrap the value. Okay, so let me use one way here. Okay, so I am going to use if let statement. Okay, so as you can see guys, I am using this kind of statement to unwrap the value, and here you can print the name. Okay, so let me print the name, and now let's run it. So guys, you can see it is successfully unwrapped the value. Okay, so this is the way how you can perform the optional chaining. Okay, so let me show you some more examples. So how you can access the subscripts through optional chaining. So let me show you one example. This is a very large example, so let me copy it and let me comment these all things and let me paste it here. So guys, I have a school class and I have a student class. Okay, so a student can have a school and the school can have some classes, and it is returning the number of classes by counting the classrooms. Okay guys, as you can see, and I have a script subscript. So this subscript basically I'm going to use to return a particular class by passing an you know what, integer value. Okay, so if I pass the integer value, it's gonna return the return class from the classes array. Okay, so as you can see guys, this is the classes array. I have a function that is print a number of rooms. Okay guys, so don't worry about these you know what warnings. So let's what happens. So I will have to correct them. I will have to remove these you know what warnings. So let me remove these warnings and then I will come back. So guys, we have removed all the warnings here. Okay guys, so guys, basically we have a student class and there is a school class. The school can have the classes and we are returning the number of classes here, and we have uses the subscript to return the to return a particular class by passing the you know what, integer value. So if you pass the integer value, so I think if you know about how to declare the subscripts or how to use the subscripts, then this code is very understandable. Okay, so I'm not going through this. And there is a print number of classes function that's gonna print the number of classes. Okay, and we have a variable that is address variable. Okay, so it can hold the instance of this class. Okay, so this class can have a name or B number. Okay, and contact address. So if I call this function, then it's gonna return the whole you know what, address. Okay guys, and there is a classroom variable, so it can have a classroom name. Okay, so I have created a one instance of school, and guys, as you can see, I am trying to append one classroom to our classes. Okay, to this schools. Okay, so I am directly creating one instance and going to assign to this school variable, that is classes variable. So in this array I have assigned a classroom, and here I'm gonna print the result. So with the help of, so I'm gonna create an instance of a student with result variable. So result I have printed, and I have assigned a school instance to our student. Okay, so as you can see, if you go through the student class, then it can hold a school instance. Okay, so here finally I am going to extract the school, and because okay, so if I am passing school with subscript bracket value, then it's going to return a particular class. So if you are remember, then in the school we have assigned classroom. Okay, so it's going to return that classroom. So there may be a chance you are passing one. So in the case of one, it's going to, it's not going to return any classroom. Why? Because we have appended only a single classroom. Okay, so it will be on the 0th position. Okay, so 1th position there is no any school. Okay guys, sorry, classroom. So whatever the instance it's going to return, on the basis of that instance I'm going to print the class name. Okay guys, so why I'm using this if let statement? Because this is an optional value. Okay, so because this is optional value, this whole statement can return a optional value. Okay, so there may be a chance of value or there may not be a chance of value. It might be written a nil value or it might be written a class name. So better to use if let statement so that we can access the value. So as if you understand my previous example, then this is, I don't think this is a very different example. Okay, so this is the only the concept is we can use the optional with our subscripts. Okay, so we are just accessing the subscript value. Okay, so I hope you like clarity about it. I am not going more about this example. Okay, and guys, there is one more example for the chaining on methods with optional return value. So guys, there may be a chance your method will return an optional value. Okay, so you can put an optional kind of thing also on the return type. Okay, so that if you put the optional on the return type values, then that function can return a value or that might not be return a value. Means it can return a nil value or it can return a particular type of value. Okay, so let me copy this example and let's go on the playground and let's see what I'm trying to say here. So guys, as you can see, okay, so let me comment all the all these things and let me paste it here. Okay, so I have a function that is album released, and I'm gonna pass the year here. So on the basis of year, it's gonna return the album names. Okay, so guys, there may be a chance we are passing a year which doesn't exist in this switch statement. In that case, it's gonna return nil, otherwise it's gonna return the string. Okay, so as you can see guys, the signature is saying what the return, this is a return type and this is optional. Means this kind of, this return may be a optional value. Are you getting my point? So it can return a value, it might not be return the value. Okay, so if I'm passing like this, then it's gonna print the value, and if I'm doing like this, then we are passing a year. And what is the problem here? Okay, so let me make it as album 1 and let me print the album 1 here. Okay, so because I have declared two times, that's why it is showing the error. Okay, so guys, as you can see, it is returning the string, and it is going to print, and in the same case here, it is going to return the string, and on the basis of a string I'm going to call a method that is uppercased. So this is what your optional chaining. Are you getting my point? So let me run it. So as you can see, it is returning an optional value. So you can unwrap the value, and in the earlier videos we have already seen how we can unwrap the value. So you can using the exclamation mark to unwrap, to forcefully unwrap the value. Okay, and if you want to unwrap the value type safely, in that case you can go through if-let or guard statement. Okay, so let me run it. So as you can see, it is successfully unwrapped the value, and better to take the if-let statement or the guard statement to unwrap the value. So I'm not going to show you, but just I want to show you here what guys, the optional return value. Okay, so now I hope you are having a clear clarity about the optional and optional chaining. Okay, so I will see you in the next video guys. If you like the video, then hit the like button. If you are having any issue related to this video or related to this topic, you can comment in the comment section. And if you want some improvements in my video lectures, then you can also comment in the comment section and share with your friends. Have a nice day. Happy coding. I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching this video.